Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series, and continuing our trend of duck identification videos, this one is going to cover mergansers. And if you remember back to one of my earlier videos, mergansers have these long, thin bills that are much thinner than what you typically think of as a duck bill. And there are three species to cover, each with male and female plumages, so six total plumages to cover. Let's start with what I think is the most distinctive of them, and this is male hooded merganser. Hooded mergansers have a little bit more compact structure than you see on the other two species, but of course they still have that thin bill, and the males have dark bills. Their plumage overall is black and white, but they also have a rich brown color in the sides. And of course, they also show this extensive white hood. And they can open and close the hood, so you can see extensive white, or you can see when it's a little bit more closed, there's a lot less white. So let's take a look at female hooded mergansers. And you can see, largely, it's a very similar structure to the males. They also have the hoods, but instead of the black and white, they're just more brown overall. And a lot of times you'll see a little bit of yellow in the bill instead of the all dark bill that the males have. And similar to what I've mentioned in other videos, the non-breeding males and immature males actually can look pretty similar to the females. And for an introductory video, I'm not going to worry about those specific differences. I think it's more important that you're able to identify it to species. So when I say female plumage, a lot of times I really mean female type plumage. And let's take a look at these side by side. Again, you can see the very similar structure between these two. They both have the hoods, but the male plumage is overall black and white with the rich brown in the side, and of course the white in the hood, and the female overall is just brown. Let's move now to common merganser, and males have mostly white in the body with black on the back and a dark head that can either look green or black depending on the lighting. They also have a pretty strong red color in the bill. And you can really see the elongated structure compared to the compact structure of hooded merganser. And you can see that same elongated structure on the female plumage. And the overall plumage is quite a bit different than males. You can see they have an overall grayish body with brown heads, and they also do have a red bill like males. And one thing that can be very helpful on these is the white chin. One other thing to notice is that females often have this sort of messy crest off of the back of the head, and you don't really see that in male common mergansers. And we can take a look at these side by side. Again, you can see that sort of messy crest off of the back of the head of these two females, and you don't really see that on the males. And for a quick review of plumage, males have a dark head, either green or black, with mostly white in the body, black on the back, and red bills. Females also have the red bills, and they have brown head with a white chin, and then overall gray in the body. So now we can move on to male red-breasted mergansers. These also have sort of that messy, wispy crest, although it's pretty strong in red-breasted merganser, particularly in the males, which is the opposite of common merganser, where the females are the stronger crest. And these have a dark head with a brown or reddish breast, and then a thick white band between them. And then they have very dark backs with gray sides and a big white stripe between them. And red-breasted mergansers have very long and very thin bills, even compared to common merganser. On the females, we can also see some of those structural things with the wispy crest and also that very thin and long bill. And overall, they look like a lower contrast version of female common merganser, with the brown head and the gray body, but they have a little more diffuse transition from the head color to the body color, and also they don't have that white chin that you saw on common merganser. And you'll often see birds like this, especially during spring migration, where they have this dark ring around the eye, which is something that the immature males develop that time of year. But my understanding is that the older adult females can also show that. And we can take a look at these together. And really, the thing that stands out is that very long, thin bill. And to quickly review the plumages, the males have dark heads with a brown or reddish breast, the white band between them, sort of black, then white, then gray on the body. And they also have a wispy crest and a long, thin red bill. And the females have a brown head with a gray body with a very low contrast transition here in the neck area. They lack the white chin of common merganser. And like male red-breasted mergansers, they also have that long, thin red bill. And let's just do a quick direct comparison between common and red-breasted, and we'll start with the male plumage. In the head, the main differences are the bill shape. You can see this much thicker base of the bill in common merganser compared to the thinner base in red-breasted merganser. And red-breasted merganser also has the wispy crest that you don't see in male common mergansers. And while both have black in the back, red-breasted has a lot more color in the sides and the front, where you have this gray pretty low on the side of the body, then this black area, and ending with that brown or reddish color in the breast. And the females, I think, are where most of the confusion comes in. Both of them can show sort of wispy crests, so don't really rely on that when you're trying to tell these apart. And there's really three key things that you want to be looking for on these. So first of all, there's a much stronger contrast here between the head color and the body color on common merganser. You can see this very sharp cutoff here. And compare that to the much more diffuse transition between the colors here in red-breasted merganser. Second, you can look at the chin area. There's usually high contrast white in the chin of common merganser, but you don't really see any white in that area on red-breasted merganser. And then the bill structure is one of the most crucial things to get this identification right. Remember that red-breasted has a longer and thinner bill that barely seems to get any taller at the base. And common merganser has maybe a little bit shorter bill, but it definitely looks a lot thicker at the base. And even if you're in pretty poor lighting conditions, usually that difference is pretty apparent and is pretty reliable to separate these species. And we'll take one final look. Hopefully you can tell them apart at this point. Red-breasted merganser here, then common merganser, and hooded merganser. If you're finding these duck identification videos helpful, please subscribe to the channel. There's more duck ID videos on the way soon. And if you're interested in receiving a daily bird ID quiz in your email inbox, you can sign up for that at lycobirds.com/email. It's free and easy to unsubscribe at any time. And I hope you'll join me in my next video. Thanks for watching.